And today I want to share with you about serving. And in Nike, what's Nike's slogan?
Just do it.
Just do it. I know Pastor Nicholas Chu shared a very powerful sermon 2 weeks ago at Battle on this. Just do it. About serving God. Today I want to tell you, don't just do it. Yes, don't just do it. But I want you to do it right. Pastor Nicholas was sharing about serving God. If you're not serving God, time to serve Him. It was a totally different points from what I'm going to share. But today I'm addressing a different group of leaders. People who are serving God. People who are so committed. People who have given their time, effort, resources, money, sacrifices to serve Him. And there's something that is tugging at me. And what I want to us to know is to do it right. How do it right? God is not just interested in our sacrifices alone. But God also wants us to do it right. And that's the very thing that I want to share with you. I want to share with you from Hosea chapter 6, verse 6. By the way, Hosea is a Hokkien, a Hosea. Yeah? So it's a luck, okay? Okay, what does Hosea say? For I desire mercy and not sacrifice, and the knowledge of God rather than burnt offerings. And it was something that struck me. Lord, you mean our sacrifices is not enough for you? Our service is not enough for you? That what you desire is mercy. And it brought me through these few months to search. Lord, what are you trying to tell us? What is it that you want us to hear? What is it that you want us to know? That these leaders who have given so much of their time, week in, week out, every week, doing everything, and now I hear your word that I desire mercy and not just sacrifices. What's in need for us, Lord? And it was a big, big struggle. And I even had to talk to some of the staff and ask them, how do I carry this through? Each of you have given so much, but what's the message here? I found out that the mercy word found in Hosea 6:6, the Hebrew word is called hesed. Hesed means love in Hebrew. And it is a very powerful word here. If I can paraphrase this verse for you, it says, for I desire love and not sacrifice and a knowledge of God. That means to know God, not just with our effort, not just serving Him, but what's the heartbeat of God? What is the heartbeat of God? Not a blind service, not a blind faith. But where do we go from here? What do we do, Lord? You know that Jesus, in Matthew chapter 9, verse 13, He also quoted this verse. When He was dining at the disciple Matthew's house, the people were saying, why do you eat with the sinners? And He says, it is not the well who needs a doctor, but those who are sick. And He says, that God desires mercy and not sacrifice. And what is mercy here? I bring you to Titus chapter 3, okay, verse 4 and 5. The mercy, to understand the love that in Hosea 6:6, I bring you to Titus, it says, but when the kindness and the love of God our Savior towards man appeared, not by works of righteousness which we have done, but according to His mercy, He saved us. The mercy here that God is talking about is His kindness and love. The mercy of God here is talking about the kindness and love of God. That means, if you bring back to Hosea, it's talking about the kindness and love of God that He is more interested in than our sacrifice. It is something that I want us to walk with. You know, Rangers, I always tell each and every one of us, it's just the beginning. Even though some of us have been serving 30 years, it's still the beginning. Because when we serve God, the only end is when it comes to our time. That's our end. As long as tomorrow is still a beginning. So we don't look back 30 years or 20 years alone. We look back to praise God. But we must remember that serving God will always be a journey. And if we don't get this attitude of our service right, do you know that sometimes you ask yourself, Lord, why my struggle, why my burden is so heavy? When the Lord has told you that I will carry your burden for you. And that is the very thing that God wants us to remember, that we serve Him with kindness and love, not with just our sacrifice. That means, my chuk gulat niya. Don't just be a bull. Okay? But use our heart, examine our heart and our attitude towards Him when we serve Him. And there's two things that God desires in each of us. Alright? First, in 1 Samuel chapter 5, verse 15, verse 22, is obedience. He says, behold, to obey is better than sacrifice. That was what Prophet Samuel told King Saul. When King Saul disobeyed God, when God told him to wipe out all the enemies and their livestock and everything, but King Saul kept what was good and offered as a sacrifice to God. To King Saul, why waste? I'm sacrificing it to you. I'm doing the right thing. That is King Saul's. But what God was saying to King Saul through Prophet Samuel was, I desire obedience. Now, I don't want to talk about that. I'll let the pastors talk about it in your church. But the obedience part is talking about a relationship. It's between you and God. Alright? Now, it's your relationship with God. The second thing that God desires is what I said just now, mercy. In Hosea chapter 6, verse 6. It is your service to God. That means, these are the two things. First, you remember, when you have obedience, the Ten Commandments and the laws and the fulfillment of everything is inside there, you know, you already fulfilled it. If you really look at it, it's in one word, obedience. If you look at your service to God, it's after your salvation, you are serving Him, like what you are doing today. We want to talk about our attitude in serving Him. Now, to give you a few illustrations is the story of Mary and Martha. When Jesus went to Martha's house, she was so happy. She started getting busy and serve Him. So busy preparing the food, doing everything. While the sister Mary sat at Jesus' feet and listened to Jesus. After a while, Martha gets so frustrated that the sister is not helping her or leaving her alone in the kitchen. And she complained to Jesus. And Jesus said, Martha, Mary has done the right thing. You and I are very familiar with this story. If you read, understand carefully in that passage, what Jesus is basically saying, I'm not concerned about the food or what you're going to feed me with. What I want you to be concerned with is with the spiritual things. To spend your time and resources to receive the spiritual things. Don't be concerned about trying to make it that to serve me alone. But what I want you to know is to hear from me. What are the spiritual things that God has in place? And of course, by sharing this, it means like maybe our next camp I would have any supper already. Okay, later y'all will know why. Alright. Now, later